So welcome to this presentation. I would like to show you a presentation about the new system to analyze ergonomics in automotive. We have the possibility to understand the importance to have a very dynamic tools, analytic tool, to analyze automotive ergonomics in this moment of the study, in this moment of the current according to the current technology. You know the definition of the ergonomy. Ergonomy is designed to study man-machine interface, and the purpose of the ergonomy is to understand the feeling of the user inside of the car, but also to care the wellness, the visibility, the acoustic and thermal comfort of the user. So to have biggest possible analysis of the human-machine interface. Also safety is affected by ergonomic study, from my opinion. BIOMOVIE is very useful because help us ourselves to understand the condition of the user of the car, instead to have a simple static tools. We know that actually the most technological and innovative software that is used in project in engineering use 3D dummy, but this dummy is don't give us all information about the movement. It is quite static. We need to integrate this information with a real user movement, consider 95 percentile, for example, and to having also the weight of the user that normally we haven't in the ergonomic information. So normally ergonomic is static and is follow according the standard rules, the standard established by the law or necessary for homologation of the car. We want to have more information about the user, because normally ergonomic is managed in this deal like a human machine interface, but more like machine human, is more machine that drive and carry on human function, and is studied more machine than human. We want to try to change this particular philosophy and to study more human than car, and to see how the human change according the environment, improving the environment, reducing the bad changing of the human in order to avoid discomfort, pathology, and increase safety and quality of the product. So summary, you have these 4 points that help us to understand why I started to study a new way to manage ergonomic in automotive environment. We want to analysis more precise as possible regarding the real human performance. We want to evaluate any motor strategy. We want to have a dynamic study of the human-machine interface, to have an objective analysis of the competitor reference model that actually lacking in the project. The bottom line is not present when we start a new project. We want to have the analysis of the competitor in order to have a sort of bottom line starting our project, having this information and increasing the level of the bottom line. We want to create a new database creation. We want to increase sharing of basic engineering data related to the reference model between the engineering development department. You see here in which way it is possible to put our analysis in the process. I can add another step, the sixth step. We can use BIOMOVIE now. You will see some movie. We can use BIOMOVIE in crash test, in crash analysis also. Normally, BIOMOVIE enter in the standard. You know that this is the standard number standard, and any of these number is related an angles or a certain measurement. But I repeat, it's in a static way, b-dimensional. Only Ramses use three-dimensional dummy. Sometimes, if you want to have information about the competitor cars, or the reference car, or benchmarking cars, we ask the autograph interchange, but we have only volume of this car. We have nothing about the function of the user inside of the car, of the ergonomy, of the feeling, the cognitive aspect. This is dummy, 3D dummy, normal user that use the car in the same environment, is the same car, but we read different data, different expert. We have another point of view, very useful to increase quality, to reduce error, and to increase economical benefit of the project, because we reduce the possibility to make errors. In this slide is a static picture. You can see the analysis of posture that is possible to do, static and of course also dynamic. I can analyze centimeter instantaneously the distances in centimeters and the area of movement of the finger for reachability. I can use sensor. You see here is the sensor, is inertial sensor. Inertial sensor are accelerometer, magnetometer, and gyroscope together, and I can read in this axis is a zeta axis, but is X axis for the automotive expert. In the X axis, I see the movement of the trunk, of the torso of the user to touch this aspect of the car. And here I see that the my user go to the right. This is the left. You see the zero area. Under the zero is right. Upper the zero is left. And upper the zero is in front. Under the zero is a back. And consider this aspect, I have all information about the movement of the user, even when he moved the back or the torso from the seat to touch something. I can add also vertical information, but is not useful for me in car, according my opinion. The line yellow that you see in this graph is the line that sign the time in which we are in this moment of the analysis. So we read this moment. This moment is correspondent of the picture that you see. So this is the line time. We can analysis from up of the cars, looking at the way to manage the handles, or the way in which the athlete put his elbow in different part of the car, or the shoulder asymmetry, and many other aspects that can induce some injuries or pathology. We can use external sensor to analyze, like here in a pad and a mat, to analyze pressure in a dynamic way. We can analyze thermal comfort. This is a thermocamera imaging that give us the information about the area that was in the contact with the body, making a 2 euros coin. We can take a size, and we can analyze any dimension, even dimension and area of the contact, the area of seat contact with the user. So we can analyze visibility and posture. We can analyze area of conflict and posture. We can analyze the area of movement, having the P point that give problem in access of the car, having all movement with the acceleration. You see the lila, this color is acceleration data with minimum, maximum, and average. And we can have length, instantaneous speed, or we can have the average of the speed. You see here the area of entry with a P point that give problem to the access. In the automotive engineering and automotive ergonomic, normally we need to analyze this the point P size, the point P dimension. It's possible to do the same with the BIOMOVIE data, but in real cars with a real user inside. I can evaluate also the ergonomy outside, handle height, handle different handle work to take something in the luggage, for instance my luggage, or to have the emergency wheel, or to calculate the energy cost to make management of the car, or many other aspects. I can analyze angular speed. So angular speed is the speed that I record when I close my leg. Angular speed is very simple information but very useful. It is the velocity in which the angle change close or open himself in the time. In this case, close. More is high. The speed of this angle means that more is easy for the user to bend his body, to bend his joint, and to enter in the car. But we have area of movement like before. With the angular speed, we can analyze entry and exit of the car in a very simple way. And here you see the accelerometer data. I spoke to you before about the epsilon axis is a lateral movement, and zeta or x axis for automotive movement, automotive car, that determine anterior posterior movement. This is angular speed information. It's quite complicated to explain you now, but it's possible to have angular speed also by my gyroscope. It's possible also to analyze, you see I take two different markers to analyze entry and P point that is give problem in the access of my car. What I discovered that is quite very, very interesting, that the posterior part of this rectangle is a functional vertical line, is determined a vertical line that pass through the H point. So H point is through this line, is in on this line, and this has some physiological answer, physiological quest, physiological reason, and is interesting because H point is not described in literature. You don't find nothing that describe H point scientifically, or how you can find H point scientifically. And here, so you have no validation of the H point. Here you see another aspect in which I have the vertical line. I can define H point. I can track the horizontal line 20 centimeters from this line. I can track another vertical line that give me the size of the P point respecting to this line. This is a one standard for automotive. I can analyze handle and area of load and the height of load edge, area in which my pedon can impact of pedestrian. And now I want to show you some video that could help you in a very interesting way, could help you to understand the advantage and the powerful of this program, and how you can analyze your ergonomic information using the software. I think that is one of the most powerful tools. Imagine that I can do not this movement, of course, but other movement, even driving the car. So in the truck or in the road, I can drive in the car, my car, and I can analyze all information about my car function. It's very interesting this, because I can, you see here, angular the movement and entry and exit with the acceleration. Okay, this is the color. I have distances, instantaneous speed, average of the speed and acceleration, and any information regard angles. For instance, I can read the angles of the wheel. You will see in another in another video, probably I can analyze angle of the wheel, and many other aspects of my ergonomy in analyzing my ergonomy. So you see here the area of movement of the foot with the angular speed and the height of foot to enter in the car in this P point. We go back and we see that in this video I have the movement in which I record the angular of the wheel. Yes, you see here. I show you still. Okay, here is the angular of the wheel respecting this line, the vertical line that represent 19. This line, horizontal line, represent 0 or 360, and this line respect 90 is 180.89. But it's a very interesting way to analyze any angles without having 3 points. So you see analysis of the angle. This is myself. I'm myself, but I'm not 95 percentile, of course. But I was voluntary. So I use myself to show you in which way is possible to analyze also the movement of my body, of the track point, this point, to X and to Y area. X is the vertical and Y is the lateral. So I can see any movement in the vertical, any movement in the lateral. And you will see as this aspect is important in a crash test. I also analyze distances that I need to do, or the track, the road that I need to carry in my area of movement. Instantaneous speed, average the speed and acceleration as before. You see here the movement analyzed with my accelerometer. I want to stop it because there is something that is interesting that for you to show. You see enter and exit. Y, remember, is a Y. Zeta, remember, is a X. And you see here is the moment in which the user go to the left to take the handle of the door and go far. Okay, go in front to take the handle of the door with the trunk. And here is the moment in which the door, closing the door, you receive, or the user receive, vibration. So you can also objective how much your door work. You see now, remember that the yellow line is the line of time. We are reading the line of time this moment. Okay, you see. Either at the moment in which I close the door. So I synchronize my data with my information taken by video. Here is the shoulder point. I don't use each point. I prefer shoulder point. In my shoulder point, I make a grid. Okay. Distance, centimeter, moment by moment. Area of movement. Two track. One, give me average of the speed, instantaneous speed and acceleration, and this, the finger, the point of the finger, give myself the information about the area of movement or the area in which the user touch the ground, touch the panel. You see that if the panel is clear, the line is vertical. If the panel is not clear, the line is horizontal, because you lose time to seek or to looking for the button, because I give to him many information. For instance, touch the volume of the radio, touch the hazard emergency button, and other information like this. So if the design is clear and if it's visible, we see a very vertical line. Otherwise we see more horizontal. Why we must to choose this method? Because we have a better evaluation in comparison with the reference car. We increase knowledge. We have an automotive project really center of the user function. We verify without many expensive tests, and we are more closer to the reality. We increase customer quality perception. We have a reduction of working hours and cost. This is very important considering the economical time. We increase safety in the car. Consider that it's possible for me to analyze all this information even during driving. So it's possible for me to analyze the physical and neurophysical cost of driving a car, because I can analyze, for instance, in a 4 hour of car, how much the effort is necessary in the first 30 minutes and how much the effort is necessary in the last 30 minutes of the fourth 4 hours. And I can make a delta by these two data, and I have the cost of to driving the car. This is possible using my software. Consider that I can use on my software to take any information regarding time of reaction, and we know that time of reaction, since we use neurotransmitters, and neurotransmitters disappear with the stress, the time of reaction increase with the stress. Not reducing the time, but we increase the time to react. I can analyze the time to react after 2 hours, 1 hour, 3 hour, 4 hour driving, and this is a very new information. Moreover, I create a sort of instrument to analyze and to share information with the person, having information about the study, having all file, all video, and having the document. I show you now how this it work. Remember, this is of course my conclusion of presentation, but I show you now the other two experts. I have, as you see, a BIOMOVIE folder. The weight is not too much, you see, it's possible to send without any problem, and I contain in this analysis, I contain many information. I have many video, of course, and I can have my password, okay, MNT. This is my password, what I choose for analysis, for show you the analysis. I have the video, you see the video. I can have the keyframe, and I can click on the keyframe 2 times, having the keyframe, okay, and going from one keyframe to another keyframe, simply clicking with like a PowerPoint, okay, with PowerPoint analysis. I can of course change the video, having whole video, different video. You see how many video I put in my analysis, okay? All this video you saw, this video, okay, this is a video that you never see until now, is a visibility and posture of the user. And I have of course another possibility. If when I have a dynamic video like this, I can go I can move frame by frame my video, you see, clicking like this, I go and move frame by frame, so can analyze in a very slow way. And I can open also a document, clicking 2 times, I open a document, PDF document, that give me all information that is stored in my document. You see, okay? And this is my presentation that I done for you in Italian language. Of course, when this is open, now we close this, in the media folder, I find not only the pictures, but also the movie. You see the movie? If I close my presentation and I open still, like we go to open the same folder, excuse me, but I open not the presentation, I don't find the video, so a person cannot catch the video. You protect in this way your information. The other aspect very useful for us, that I think is very useful for you to understand the potentiality of my software, is the last expert that I want to show you regarding crash test. So I can analyze in a crash test reduction of the speed in the car, reduction of the speed in you see the reduction of the speed in the car, reduction of the speed in the user, and the changing of the angle of the car. you see that the car beat, and the moment it would beat, the car changing angle. Look. And I have the two angle, the amount of changing of the angle of the car during the crash, with the reduction and the space that is used by the user and is made by the user to make this movement. I can have other kind of information. I show you now. Okay, we can read the same information, but in this is a user deceleration, this is a car deceleration, okay? So we see that, for instance, stopping the data, that the minimum for the user is 9.94, the minimum for the car is 9.52, means that I have more acceleration or deceleration in the user than not in the car. This means no safety, no good aspect. In the future, I am available also, and we are able also to calculate the deformation of the car, okay? And we will have also these tools. We elaborate also other kind of information, for instance, this kind of information, basing from this video. You see the average speed of airbag, and consider the delta respect the speed of the head is too high. And here you have the speed. This determines probably different physical problem to the user. And I think that one of the physical problem of the user is deceleration. So we can elaborate deceleration, putting the sensor or the marker here and the marker here. You see the deceleration of the user. We started deceleration of the user. Last deceleration is 4.45. Deceleration of the seat is the half, means that we have a lot of deceleration in the body. It means that seatbelt don't contain good, the seat don't contain good, airbag don't give height safety. So we can improve with innovation this aspect. We can increase innovation using this tool and having this expert, having this information. But what's happening in the body by this kind of, in the muscle, thanks to this deceleration negative? Angular speed, you see here, look, we have a decrease of the angle, not so dramatic, but we have a dramatic increase of the angular speed, instantaneous angular speed. You remember the angular speed, what mean? So we increase a lot. We arrive, we reach to 293.72 degree per second. It's too much. Consider that a disc athlete that launched the disc in the Olympic Games arrived to 600, double. But is an athlete, is training for reach this kind of movement, this kind of angular speed. For a person, a normal user that drive a car, this angular speed is dramatically height and determine many back problem, lumbar problem, and spine problem. So we can do more to protect the user, but remember, we can take information having without having electronic, without using electronic, only by the ISP video. I think that this is very incredible. It's a huge information that we can catch. I give you more other information about what is possible to do outside. You see here, I have a car, the car starting, okay, and we want to analyze acceleration of deceleration of the car. So we elaborate our file in this way. So I take the marker here, and you see here that I have average of the speed and instantaneous speed. In this moment, when the two graphs, white and orange, divide, okay, are divided, it's because I increase, or the car increase, the instantaneous speed. That is great. Means that I accelerate in this moment. But I can calculate the moment from which the car started, because I can put the marker with my video, and I can stop it here, and I can put another marker to analyze the measurement, to have the measurement, how many centimeter or meter the car need to overcome its inertial force, determined by the mass of the car, determined by the power of the engine, determined by the wheel efficiency. So I can study many experts in my analysis, in my video analysis. I can do many crash tests discovering the errors. For instance, in this Formula One test, I have the crash test that want to analyze what's happened in horizontal sense, and they ties by these tools the carbon the car, but the car move vertically. You remember X and Y? So look, Y is a blue. How the car when beat vertically goes up. And in this way, I can calculate the error of the measurement, or I can compare different measurement in different part of the car. In the future, we can analyze tests like this, having deformation and calculating deformation of the car back and in front. We can also calculate vibration and the average of vibration movement. You see here the marker is 1.69, and look here the movement of the same marker is 2.08 centimeter, but is interesting the estimate speed in which the vibration from this arrived to this. Here is a 162, and here is a double. From the physiological point of view, this is an aspect very interesting. This is a contact time. This aspect is very interesting and can help physiologists to prevent injuries in this athlete. But using the same tool is possible for me to read the vibration in any instrument. So I want you remember the possibility to show all this movie in in my channel. I show you now my channel, that is this www.youtube.com/ergonomic tool. When you open this channel, you will find ergonomic tools in with all my video, and you have all the video that I show you to you is possible for you to see. Remember this address to show my video, and in this way you can have a the real possibility to remember me and remember BIOMOVIE. You can contact me. Contact me is very easy, or sending me an email, or contacting me by Ergo Consult. So you can clicking myself, clicking finding me Mauro Testa or Ergo Consult, or you can click sending me an email in this address info@ergoconsult.it, and remember this is my address, email address. Okay, is too much. Okay, and ergoconsult.it. Okay, this is my email address. Don't remember me. Don't forget me. Don't remember me. Don't forget me. Remember the last thing, that is possible for me to analyze any time of reaction of the person, even in the car. And I show you. You can see how it's possible to analyze time of reaction in my athletes. I work in the soccer, but you see that it's possible for me to analyze in a millisecond time of reaction and acceleration of my athletes. So I can analyze the movement of my goalkeeper, in this case, from the right side to the left side, having for all moment of the test, this is a right side, this is a left side, I can analyze his time of reaction. Of course, what is possible to do in the car, in the sport, is also possible to do in the automotive, analyzing time of reaction of the user and to see how the neurotransmitter are disappear for the stress. I think that is a very big useful information. So thank you very much for your attention, and I hope to hearing you and to have your interest in these new tools for ergonomic analysis.